here's where we're gonna go. I'm gonna give you guys three options of what you can do with them. You have a single modality day, a couplet, or a triplet. Talk about couplets first. A couplet is basically taking two of those and combining them. So we'll take a movement from weightlifting, combine it with gymnastics, weightlifting, monostructural, weightlifting, weightlifting, then we'll take gymnastics, 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 monostructural, and monostructural, monostructural. That's pretty much all the possible combinations of couplets that you can pair up. Now let's take a weightlifting and gymnastics. What would be a classic example of that couplet? Fran, exactly. The workout you guys did yesterday. Fran is a thruster, which is your weightlifting movement, and a pull-up, which is your gymnastics movement. Weightlifting monostructural, anyone have an example of a movement that would involve those two? Nancy, thank you. Nancy is weightlifting, overhead squat, monostructural is the run. So it's an overhead squat and a run. Overhead squat, 15 reps at 95 pounds, run 400, repeat 5 times. Weightlifting, weightlifting, we're thinking something like deadlift and push press, maybe those two combined. Gymnastics, gymnastics, think maybe muscle up and air squat, two movements like that combined. Gymnastics Metcon, think pull-ups and run. There's a workout called Nicole that is max pull-ups and then run 400. Metcon, Metcon, there we have a good example of that would be run 400, row 500, 5 rounds for time. That's a pretty brutal workout. Think about that for a second. Run 400, row 500, 5 rounds for time. I gave this lecture in Ann Arbor, and one of the guys, the next about 2 days later after the seminar, emailed me, and he's like, dude, I did that workout. He's like, that was insane, the run and row. He's like, I can't believe I did that, and it just crushed all his clients. They said they had just a horrible experience with it. Now, with these, we're looking at movements. Let's take, give me a weightlifting movement and a gymnastics movement that couple nicely. You want to have movements that couple well. You guys, let's give me a weightlifting movement. Push press, good. We'll say push press. And then give me a gymnastics movement. Pull up, yeah, that's a nice little stimulus there. Those are, so this is exactly what you can do. And how many of these weightlifting gymnastics combos could you come up with? Probably, you know, I don't know how many, but a lot, a ton, 20, 30. And then we look at this, we take a look at weightlifting monostructural, and you can pair up any of these movements with any of these things. Gymnastics monostructural, take one of these movements and pair it up with one of these. Let's pick one. Pick something from down here. Running, and pair that up with what? Air squats or sit-ups, yeah, whatever you want. And that's what we're looking at here to make these nice couplets. Couplets and triplets are really the heart of good, effective CrossFit programming. If you guys float around the main site and work off the main site, you'll see that for the most part, most of the workouts stay in this realm. They are simple, they use these really functional movements, and they hang out in couplets and triplets, and you get an amazing dose from that. So what would a triplet be? Well, it's pretty obvious. We'll take all three of those and combine them. We could take weightlifting, gymnastics, and monostructural. I'm not going to go over all the possible combinations because that'd be really long, but what would be a good example of a triplet with that?
Helen.
Helen, yes. So Helen is, it's run 400. This is your Metcon effort. 21 kettlebell swings, that's your weightlifting effort. And then 12 pull-ups. Oops, 12. 3 rounds, and that's your gymnastics effort. That's a pretty common triplet, and you can do that with anything. You can take, let's say, deadlift 21 reps, gymnastics, say, handstand push-ups, and we'll say row 400. You can program, you can select any of those movements and program them in. Another classic triplet would be a weightlifting. What workout's that? Linda, three bars of death. All of you who know what Linda is are cringing right now because that's a brutal workout. It's deadlift 1.5 times your body weight, bench press 3/4 of your body weight, or bench press your body weight, and then clean 3/4 of your body weight, all starting at 10. You do 10, 10, 10, then 9, 9, 9, 8, 8, 8, all the way down to one. It's one of the more notorious CrossFit workouts out there. And for you bigger guys, it's really hard because what's 1.5 times your body weight? You're 270? Yeah, that's close to 400 pounds or something. I can't do math. That's a lot of weight. So you're deadlifting a lot of weight. People ask me a lot on this workout, on Linda, how should I do the cleans? Should I power clean or should I squat clean? Again, I tell them, I don't care. Just pick a way and do it. I actually recommend you try it both ways. Try the workout with just power cleans once, and then another time, try the workout with squat cleans. And it's your times are going to be a lot different, but that by no means mean, or does that doesn't mean it's going to be easier. Because when you're power cleaning, what are you able to do? Power cleaning being from here and catching it here and then going back down. Yeah, you're going to be able to move faster. Squat clean is what you guys learned with the medicine ball. That's when you get all the way underneath it and then stand up with it. But for this move, for this workout, we're doing it with the barbell. So you get underneath it all the way down and then stand up.
We just called it a clean all weekend, right?
Yeah, we just called it a clean. When we say clean, 90% of the time, the default is a squat clean. If it says power clean, then you do power cleans. And obviously, we can have any type of triplet here. You could have weightlifting, gymnastics. You could have gymnastics, monostructural. And there's a ton of triplets you can program. Beyond this, there are workouts that have four modalities. There are workouts that have five modalities. What would be a workout that has five? Bike on bad, exactly. The workout we did today has five. And that workout was created to meet the time domains of a UFC fight. A UFC fight is 5-minute rounds, 1-minute rest, and then most of them are 3-minute or 3-round events, except for the championship fights are 5 rounds. There is a version in CrossFit of a fight gone bad called the championship version. That's a 5-round version, but not too many people go there and try that. Could you guys imagine having to do 2 more rounds of that today? No, yeah, exactly. And then we have another thing called a chipper, which I'm going to briefly touch on. So a chipper is you take a set number, let's say we're going to take 5 movements. We'll say we have movement 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And then we're going to say you have to do a certain number of reps at each of that movement before moving on. So we'll say we're going to make it 50. You have to do 50 here. Then once you're done with all 50, you do 50 of this. Then once you're done with all 50, you do 50, 50, and then 50. There is a filthy 50, but that's not 5. How many is that? 10. That's 10, yeah. Here's the reason a chipper is called a chipper. You see on the side of the road when you're driving through Middletown suburbia or Middletown America, the machine where the guy's chopping down branches and putting it in the wood chipper, and you're putting it in, and on the other end it's being spit out as mulch. Well, when you start this workout, you're being put in the machine, and by the time you finish it, you're the mulch. You're laid out, and you're done for the day. Now, those are good to play with, but these here, I'd like to see occasionally. I'd like to see a heart of the majority of your training staying over here in these couplets and triplets. Single modality days. I got to back up 1 second. Single modality days.